There have been several examples of tragic losses within the wrestling community that have cut fledgling careers short and altered wrestling history itself. But one that could be argued as having possibly the biggest effect on the overall landscape of pro wrestling is the auto accident that cut short the career of Magnum TA. Former Virginia State amateur wrestling champion Terry Allen burst onto the wrestling scene in the historic Florida and Portland wrestling territories, capturing championship gold alongside well-known tag partners Scott McGee, Brad Armstrong, and Dusty Rhodes. The last name mentioned would end up becoming a major part of his career later on. It wasn't until he was in Bill Watts' hard-nosed Mid-South territory that Allen made the decision to switch his name to Magnum TA, ironically at the suggestion of Andre the Giant, of all people. Magnum PI, starring Tom Selleck, was one of the hottest shows on television at the time, and based on Allen's good looks and prominent mustache, it was suggested he take on the moniker combining his initials with the Magnum name. The American heartthrob started to make a name for himself as someone to watch while in Mid-South, briefly winning the North American title in late 1983, and then again in 1984 after defeating his mentor and former tag team partner Mr. Wrestling 2 in a memorable feud. He would drop that title to Ernie Ladd 5 months later before departing for the territory where he would gain his greatest fame. Magnum debuted in the NWA's strongest territory, Jim Crockett Promotions, in late 1984. He immediately made an impact by feuding with the legendary Wahoo McDaniel for the United States Heavyweight Championship, a title that would be synonymous with him throughout his career. After capturing his first U.S. Heavyweight Championship in March 1985, Magnum would go on to defend the title throughout the spring and summer of that year until losing it to his most legendary rival, Tully Blanchard, in July. The feud with Tully led to one of the greatest I Quit matches in wrestling history at Starrcade 85, with Magnum becoming U.S. champion for the second time in a bloody and brutal battle inside the steel cage. His battles with members of the Four Horsemen continued throughout the rest of his career. Before he could take that title off of Ric Flair, he had one more major obstacle to overcome. Russian Nightmare, Nikita Koloff. After being harassed and called out for weeks by the Russians, both Ivan and Nikita, the contract signing for the big US title matchup was set up by then NWA president Bob Geigel. Nikita was seconded by Uncle Ivan, and Magnum was joined by his mother. After repeated insults were hurled by the Russians, a fight broke out, leading to a public reprimand of Magnum by Geigel for conduct unbecoming a champion. This led to the infamous "reprimand this" quote from Magnum as he punched out Geigel. As a result of this, Magnum was stripped of his title and it was put up in a best of seven series between Magnum and Nikita. After losing the first three matches in a row to Nikita, Magnum began a comeback, winning the next three matches to keep the series going. In the tie-breaking match on August 17, 1986, Nikita defeated Magnum to win the title with help from Ivan and Crusher Khrushchev. This feud seemed to be the final stepping stone to Magnum taking wrestling's top prize, as it was assumed he would face Flair for the NWA World title at Starrcade 86, but that would never come to fruition. On October 14, 1986, Magnum was driving in his Porsche in the rain and lost control, wrapping the car around a telephone pole. Sadly, the wreck happened only a couple of miles from his home. Initially, it was suspected he was speeding, but forensic reports showed he was driving the speed limit, and he was left in his car for 2 hours before a witness called 911. The wreck caused the C4 and C5 vertebrae to explode, and it was doubted at the time whether he would ever walk again. Doctors at Carolina's Medical Center said Allen's physical conditioning saved his life. The right side of his body was paralyzed for months, ending his in-ring career. The accident changed the direction of NWA's booking going forward. Booker, Dusty Rhodes, decided to turn the heel Nikita Koloff, who himself was starting to gain popularity for his badass persona, into a babyface. According to the storyline, Koloff gained respect for Magnum from their feud and wanted to take his place. Magnum himself returned on screen following the accident on TBS's Supertowns on the Superstation in an interview with Tony Schiavone. His first appearance in front of a live crowd was at the Crockett Cup in 1987, where, with the aid of a cane and two referees, Magnum made an emotional return walking to ringside to embrace Dusty and Nikita, who would go on to defeat Tully Blanchard and Lex Luger for the tournament championship. Magnum, as the boss, Magnum TA, hosted an interview segment titled Straight Talk with the Boss on NWA Worldwide Wrestling in 1988. Magnum later worked as a commentator for the NWA, UWF, and World Championship Wrestling, and also served as a manager for Rhodes and Koloff. In his last angle in WCW in March 1988, Magnum was attacked by his former rival Tully Blanchard, which prompted Dusty Rhodes to come to the aid of his friend. Rhodes was subsequently suspended and returned as the Midnight Rider, managed by Magnum. After Rhodes signed with Championship Wrestling from Florida, and later World Wrestling Federation, and Koloff signed with the American Wrestling Association, Magnum left JCP as well, although he would make sporadic reappearances with the promotion until 1993. Due to the global reach, expansion, and dominance of WWF, and its own mismanagement, Jim Crockett Promotions would eventually be sold to Ted Turner in 1988, being renamed to World Championship Wrestling. But the question that remains in the minds of most fans of Magnum TA and JCP is what could have been if that accident never happened? Would Magnum eventually have taken the 10 pounds of gold from Flair and go on to hold that title for many years? Would Flair and Magnum have a memorable feud switching the title back and forth in classic matches? Would Jim Crockett Promotions continue its meteoric rise with Magnum as its hood ornament and stave off the challenge of WWF, possibly becoming the number one wrestling promotion in the world? Or would Magnum eventually be wooed over to WWF by Vince McMahon and become the heir apparent to Hulk Hogan as the WWF World Champion? So many what-ifs that will never be answered, and so many possibilities of a seismic change in the wrestling world. This is why I always consider the sudden end of Magnum TA's career to be one of the greatest tragedies of professional wrestling. But there is a happy ending to this story. Magnum survived. He is alive and well today. He has gone on to be a husband and a father, which is a far greater accomplishment in life than winning a wrestling championship. So let us know what you think. How great would Magnum TA's career have been? What would his ultimate contribution to the wrestling world eventually be? Leave a comment down below and let us know.